Joined by our political commentators Sally Kohn and Ana Navarro. Let's start with Ana. What are your reactions to the president's comments there?
Look, it's almost like he can't help himself. Frankly, I think this is a big moment, him being in Texas, where he could have highlighted some of the humanitarian aspects of this crisis, where he could have been big, talked about moving forward, working together. I don't see the productivity. I don't see the usefulness of doing this kind of jabbing at a moment like this, when we are at a crisis moment. Things need to get addressed seriously. Feds, state government, border folks have all got to work together, and let's just get it done and stop the partisanship. And he needs to lead with that.
Well, I love exactly what Ana just said, but with all due respect, that's exactly what the president has done. He's not interested in photo ops. He's not going to turn this into political theater. He has put a plan on the table that would address this humanitarian crisis, and it's the Republicans who are turning this into political football, using this to yet again go after the president, using this to yet again go after immigration reform by conflating the two issues. And so what do you want the president to do? I mean, he points out,
frankly,
what they're doing,
Sally,
and you try and ding him for it.
Sally, yeah. Let me just tell you, this is the first time that I've seen the president not like photo ops, because he has had plenty of photo ops on immigration and just about every other issue, as do all presidents, because what the presidency comes with is the bully pulpit and the platform, and photo ops and symbolism are sometimes very important. And let me also remind you that it's not just Republicans that have been critical of him for not going to the border when he was 500 miles away. It has been people with such credibility on the immigration issue, like Congressman Luis Gutierrez. It has been Henry Cuellar, another Democrat from the border area. So, no, it's not just Republicans being partisan. It's been Paul Begala, who was even tougher on the president last night than I was when commenting on this. So let's not make this a Republican-Democrat issue.
I love you, Ana. I am so generally sick of Republicans using every chance they can to ding the president on style and avoid the conversation about substance. Pass the legislation, solve the problem.
Along those lines, bring back in Ana Navarro and Sally Kohn to talk about this. Ana, the other thing that House Speaker John Boehner did, he said this is a problem, as Michaela was saying, of the president's own making. You know, we're talking about a 2008 law here that was passed nearly by a unanimous Congress, supported and signed by George W. Bush. Pointing fingers like this at this point, does it help solve the problem?
And I've said that many, many times on this program, John. I just think there is huge frustration going on with each other, with both sides. And, they're stuck with each other. They're stuck with each other for another 3 years. It's like when you're in a bad marriage, but divorce is not an option, well, you better learn how to deal with the situation, how to put a smile on your face, and how to move forward. And I think Speaker Boehner and President Obama have got to stop wagging fingers at each other and have got to start addressing issues, because you're stuck with each other, guys. Deal with it.
Sally, I was sort of thinking, in a way, is the president damned if he does, damned if he doesn't? You have some voices, Governor Rick Perry essentially saying, go ahead, act, lead, be a leader. And then you have John Boehner suing him for taking executive action. It's just a no-win situation.
Right.
For the
same Republicans who are suing him for, not holding up the law are the ones who don't want to uphold that 2008 law now. There's a slight profound irony there. The other thing here is, look, Republicans are taking a pre-existing immigration crisis and a new humanitarian crisis, and they're trying to conflate the two in order to inflame political tensions and continue to do nothing about either of them. There's really something important that we should note about what's happening here, which is we have 50,000 migrant kids from Central America who are fleeing violence in their home countries. They're more likely to be killed if you're a civilian in Central America than at the height of the insurgency in Iraq. They're in detention. Our border is working. These kids aren't slipping through. But Republicans are using this to try and sort of pound these old saws about, the border, we have to fix the border. The border's working. They're in detention. We have a humanitarian crisis. The president has a proposal on the table. Fix it. Deal with it. Pass it. And stop trying to turn this into a partisan issue.
The larger system working. But, the president and Rick Perry had a meeting yesterday. Since they got together and talked, what have we had since then? A whole lot of shouting between Rick Perry, the president, now House Speaker John Boehner. Someone stand up and do something.
Absolutely.